Assalamu alaikum dear friends, this is Sajid Ali. In my last lecture I discussed with you how Europeans came to India and why they came here. So when they came to India for the purpose of trade and business, they occupied India. The war of independence is our today's topic. The war of independence was fought in 1857 between East India Company and Indian, as well as leaders and Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar. So dear friends, some writers says about the war of independence that it was the uprising, it was the rebellion, and those rebelled force soldiers of East India Company who started rebellion against East India Company and their masters. But some Indian writers and Pakistani writers says about war of independence that it was not the uprising of soldiers, because every Indian people, including soldiers of East India Company, took part in the war of independence. That's why it was not the uprising and revolt in any way. So dear friends, before the war of independence, many uprisings took place. First of all, in 1806, Sir George Barlow was the governor of Madras. Who banned on the tilak and turban of Hindus. They were soldiers of East India Company. So dear friends, East India Company was the Britishers, and it made its own private army. Many of the Indians also were in the army of East India Company. In 1806, Sir George Barlow, the governor of Madras, who banned on the tilak and turban. It was the culture and tradition of Hindus. He banned on both of these, tilak and turban, at the time of cantonment and at the time of duty. So that's why the soldiers of Madras uprised, revolted against such kind of policy against East India Company. This is an uprising. And second, in 1842, about four cantonment refused to go to Sindh. It was also uprising, we can say, because there was no any common people participated in these uprisings. They were only soldiers. And also in 1859, in Punjab, Rawalpindi, and Punjab, two times soldiers revolt against East India Company. This is the uprising, because no any common men were took part in these uprisings. But in the war of independence, every Indian people took part, whether they were rulers or farmers, shopkeepers and so on. They all took part. And in the war of independence, there was no any one community. Different communities, Muslims, Hindus, and other communities, untouchables, all participated except Sikh community. So dear friends, it was fought in 1857. It was won by British East India Company. The major causes behind the War of Independence were as under: religious cause, political and immediate cause. First of all, when Dr. Fender criticized in Islam in his book, its name Mizanul Haq, so it was the religious cause to incite the people of India. British East India Company also criticized other native religions, Hinduism, Islam and some other religions, Buddhism. British East India Company also passed a law to bring priests, their religious leaders from British, especially to spread, to propagate Christianity, their religion. And they also tried to convert low caste of people, poor people, into Christianity. It was the religious cause behind War of Independence. So dear friends, what was the political cause? Political cause was that in 1843, East India Company stopped pension and tax to Mughal Emperor. It stopped pension and tax from 1843. And also, as I discussed with you about the doctrine lapse, doctrine lapse was enforced in 1848 by Lord Dalhousie, who was the Governor General of East India Company. According to it, many of the states were occupied by British East India Company, which had no the real son and real heir. So dear friends, according to the doctrine lapse, many of the states, just like Satara, Jaipur, Sambalpur, Awadh and other states, Jhansi, these all our states were occupied by British East India Company. That's why their rulers became against the policies and British East India Company. So dear friends, when doctrine of lapse introduced, Nana Sahib was also victimized, and the Queen of Jhansi, Rani of Jhansi, they tried to recover their estates from British East India Company, but they could not. Nana Sahib, his real name Dhondu Pat, he was not the son of Bajirao II. Bajirao II was the leader and Peshwa of Maratha community. But after Bajirao II, there was no leader and Peshwa of Maratha community. It was Nana Sahib who had to took the seat of Bajirao II of Maratha. But he was victimized. He was not given the seat of Marathas because he was not real son of Bajirao II. That's why he became against British East India Company. And Rani of Jhansi, She was a queen of Jhansi. Jhansi was a state. She had also no son. That's why she was also not given her estate. According to the doctrine laws, it was policy introduced by British East India Company. That's why these leaders, Rani of Jhansi and Nana Sahab, were the main leaders, took part in War of Independence. So dear friends, including Rani of Jhansi and Nana Sahab, last Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar, who also participated into War of Independence, because he was major ruler of India and the throne of Delhi. So dear friends, what was the immediate cause? Immediate cause was that British East India Company introduced cottages which was made up of the skin of cow and pig. These were cow was pious for Hindus, and pig was not pious for Muslims. And as I already said you, that in the army of British East India Company there were many Hindus and Muslims, so they refused to use cottages. It was also the reason behind the War of Independence. So dear friends, why Indians lost this war? They were in majority, but Britishers were not in majority. Even then Indian lost this war. Why? These are reasons behind it. Changing of plan. They planned to attack on British East India Company on 31st May 1857, but they attacked prematurely on 10th May 1857. That's why they lost the war. Treachery of Sikhs. Sikh community betrayed, deceived Indians, and they supported British East India Company. That's why Indians lost this war. So dear friends, no efficient leadership. There was no efficient leader. So there was no skilled and trained leader, one leader who could lead a large army. So dear friends, that's why they lost the War of Independence. The Sir John was general and leader of army of British East India Company, and Bakht Khan was the leader of Mughal army and other Indian armies. So dear friends, these leaders also supported Bakht Khan. They were common men. Including these leaders, all common men, whether Hindus, Buddhist, Muslims, they all participated. That's why we can say this is a war of independence, but not uprising. And also soldiers of East India Company took part due to the cartilage problem. And dear friends, what was the result of that war? The result of that war was that Indians lost this war, the War of Independence, and British East India Company win. After that, United Kingdom, British directly ruled over India subcontinent and ended British East India Company now. Ended the company. Now, British itself directly could make, enforce laws and rules, regulations in this way. So we discussed, we explained War of Independence. So, dear friends, thank you very much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.